I was born and raised on a dairy farm in a small town called Warriors Mark, about halfway between State College and Altoona in central Pennsylvania. And the population of the town is probably about 350 people, so pretty small little town. My very first job was really helping out on the farm and helping the family with the farm chores. I remember being really young and kind of helping out with the cows, helping out with the calves, especially feeding the calves their bottles of milk twice a day and giving them some grain and some hay and of course, shoveling manure, which is a part of every young farm boy's growing up, I think, is that, you know, that's part of the job you have to do. So we did that, and I remember always wanting to drive the tractors, and I was pretty young. Some of the first jobs I had on the tractor, my legs weren't long enough to reach the pedals, so my dad would put me on the tractor and get it started, and he'd jump off, but before I jumped off, he said, okay, just run it, you know, back and forth, and breaking the hay or tedding the hay, and when you get done with the field, just turn the tractor off, and that way you can jump off and come to the barn and let me know that you're done, and we'll get you started on the next field. So pretty young when we got started, working. Because I grew up so close to State College and Penn State University, most of my family members went to Penn State, so I wanted to be a little different, and I actually went to Cal Poly and San Luis Obispo, California. I majored in dairy science, of all things, which is not your normal major for a real estate guy. But at that point in time in my life, I thought I would get back into the dairy business. So that's one of the better dairy schools, dairy science programs in the country. I am married. I've been married now for 25 years, coming this October, to my wonderful wife, Denise. And we have four children. Twin boys that are 23 now, and they just graduated college from Penn State, and they're off on their own. And my daughter is a freshman at Penn State. She's 19, and another son who's still at home in high school, and he's 14. Really, work for me is fun, but I do need to get some stress release from time to time, and so my hobbies really include traveling. I love to travel. Love to travel around Pennsylvania. Love to travel around the United States and North America. But also like to do some traveling overseas, different countries, and travel some with the family. Travel some with my wife Denise. But I also like to go with family and friends, and we do some hunting and fishing. I'm an avid backpacker and have done a fair amount of backpacking around the United States, and so I like to get out into nature, someplace where the cell phone doesn't work, which is my goal when I'm traveling away from home. And those are the primary activities that I do to have some fun and let off a little steam. My first experience with self-storage was as a broker, and a friend of mine referred me to a client in Hanover, Pennsylvania, that had two self-storage facilities that he wanted to sell. So I met with him and looked at the numbers and looked at the financials and the performance of the properties, and I thought, wow, this is a great business. In fact, it's one of the best businesses I think I've ever seen, you know, in looking at all different types of investment real estate over the years. So that's when I said to myself, this is the business for me. And I went and did two things. I went and started my own brokerage firm to specialize in selling self-storage facilities, and we bought our first piece of land near Penn State University and built our first facility in 1997. In fact, we opened up in December 1997. I built one building, 56 units, and it was actually in a cornfield. We do a lot of community work and charitable work through many organizations. My wife and I spend a lot of time with Boy Scouts and volunteer our time there as committee members and Scoutmaster, Assistant Scoutmaster, and of course all of our boys have been involved with Boy Scouts over the years. I'm a member of York Rotary. We actually just recently formed a family foundation, so my wife and the kids and I can give back to the community through the foundation, and so we're excited about that and the future prospects for that entity and giving back to the community. So, we also bring that same sense of giving and charitable work to our to our organization, to Moove In Self-Storage and any other companies that we have. We think it's very important to give back to the community, and we strive to make sure we do that and set the example, but then also that all of our employees participate in those charitable programs as well. We've had a lot of fun with the cow theme over the years, and it really just kind of happened by accident. We had purchased our first piece of land, my father and I, and we were working on, the project and everything we needed to know, and we started talking about marketing, and we said, well, what are we going to call it? What's our name going to be? And so we're throwing out some ideas, and I said, well, we're kind of moving out of the cattle business and moving into the storage business. How about if we say we're moving out of the cow business and moving into the storage business? And I said, well, how about Moove In Self-Storage? And we can have dancing cows and do lots of fun things with cows, cow spots on the signs and on our marketing brochures and business cards, and we even built the first couple buildings with black and white, like the Holsteins we had back on the farm. So that's really the origin of the name. It happened over the dinner table, at the farm where I grew up, many years ago. Moove In Self-Storage supports local business, first of all, because we are a local business. We're located here in New York. We're a family-run business and company, and we think it's very important to be part of the communities that we serve. We strive to make sure that all of our managers, our store managers, are part of the local chamber and participate in the local chamber of commerce. We want them to get out in the community and do community service projects, charitable projects. We strive to make sure that we provide donated units to the local baseball teams and Boy Scout troops and local libraries so they have a place to store their books for the annual book sale. Things like that. We want to make sure it's important. We also, as part of our marketing efforts, do a lot of co-marketing with other businesses within our community. They're promoting our self-storage facility, and in return, we're going to promote their business with our business as well. We're all part of the of the same community, and growing up on a farm in a very small community, I've always felt that sense of belonging. And so, we hope that when we come to a community and serve that community, that we'll become part of that community. And we want to make sure that our customers feel like they're involved and they're part of our community and will patronize us, and we'll do the same for their businesses that we can. And we buy as much stuff locally as we can, to support them and support the community. So we feel it's very important. We have that family atmosphere within our company. We want to make sure that our customers feel like they're part of the family. Community is very important to us, and we want to be involved. We want to be part of your community. The first Moove In Self-Storage was in a little town named Bald Eagle, which is a suburb of Tyrone, which again is another small town, Tyrone, Pennsylvania, very near to Pennsylvania State University, Penn State. And so in the summer of 1997, we bought a piece of land, about 2 acres, and got the construction financing, and we built our first building, 56 units, and it was called Moove In Self-Storage, and we referred to it as Moove In Self-Storage number one. And very successful project, and that's the only project that I've ever built that I've sold. And we actually sold that to a good friend of ours that's still operating today, but not as a Moove In, but it's still operating self-storage and a very successful one at that. We are now up to 16 self-storage facilities that we own and operate under the Moove In Self-Storage name. We've been very blessed with the growth of our self-storage brand, or our Moove In Self-Storage brand, over the years. We've been in business since 1997. And in that time, we went from one facility opened up in December 1997, and we now have 16 self-storage facilities. So the growth has been pretty phenomenal. Almost all the facilities that we own, we have built, but we have purchased a few along the way as well. We started out with no employees. I actually answered the phone and did the rentals, and my father then met the clients there. I was actually 2 hours away from our facility, so I'd take the phone calls on my cell phone. And then I'd call my dad. He'd meet the clients at the storage facilities. We didn't have an office, so he sat in the front seat of his car, signed the lease with the tenant, sold him a lock, and moved him in. And that's how we did our first one. So then we hired our first employee, and she would meet the customers and take the phone calls and make the collection calls, what have you, to make sure it ran correctly and run the books. And then today, with our whole organization, we have about 35 employees. Not all of them are involved in running the self-storage facilities, but we have a construction division and feasibility studies and brokerage. And so we have probably nearly 20 people that run our self-storage facilities today. And it's a wonderful, great group of people to work with. Planning two expansions for next year, and then we're always on the lookout for areas that we believe are underserved that still could use some additional self-storage spaces or self-storage facilities. So I think we'll see fairly steady growth over the foreseeable future, maybe adding 2 to 3 to 4 facilities per year, but again, kind of staying close to our roots here in Central Pennsylvania, not branching out too far, and just serving the communities that we're serving currently, and then expanding slowly as we go forward into communities maybe a little bit farther from our home base here in New York. I've been pretty lucky. I one of the best decisions I ever made in my self-storage career was to be involved in the Self-Storage Association, both on a state level and on a national level. On the state level, we were one of the founding members of the Pennsylvania Self-Storage Association, and so that's been a wonderful organization. I served as the president for a number of years in the early 2000s, and it's a thriving organization today. And so they provide a lot of educational programs and seminars and meetings where we can keep abreast of what's happening in the industry on a state level. But then also, on a national level, I got involved very early, probably in 1999 to 2000, on a regional board, and then that led to a position on the national board, and then I served as a chairman of the National Association in 2007. And so the friendships and the camaraderie that I have made and have enjoyed over the years at the Self-Storage Association have been wonderful. Well, I attend all the state and national shows, but then also a lot of those people that are involved in the association, other self-storage owners, are very dear friends of mine all across the country, and even a few in foreign countries. And so all of us are constantly networking and getting together, talking about what's happening in the industry, talking about what's coming down the road and what we're going to see. And that really helps Moove In self-storage, even though we're in kind of sleepy central Pennsylvania. And of course, Baltimore is a much bigger market, but even though we're in maybe a secondary market, we really do try to provide our customers and run our facilities as if we were, one of the big national players operating in the top 25 markets, because a lot of the friends and contacts I have in the industry are operating in those markets. So we're in a very unique position where we have exposure to all those great things that are happening on the cutting edge, but we can bring those to Central Pennsylvania and offer our customers a lot of benefits and features that maybe other self-storage facilities don't. So we're very happy to maintain and be on the cutting edge of the industry here. The industry is pretty steady. I don't think we're going to see any major wholesale changes in the industry. I do think that we'll become more and more specialized in catering to various segments of the population. We have the baby boomers, and they're aging as we go forward. I'm actually the last year of the baby boomers, and so We're developing some of our units now that we're calling ultra premium spaces, where instead of having to reach down and pull up the roll-up door to access your storage unit, we're actually going to have a push button. So you can push the button and the door will automatically open up. And I think those sorts of things, cater to the seniors, cater to people who may not, want to do the physical, lifting of the doors every time they access their unit. So I think we're going to see more specialized types of storage spaces catered to, various segments of the population. Students would be another great example. We have a number of our facilities that serve local colleges and schools. And so we have those units are much smaller size typically, maybe only 5x5 or 5x10. A student typically doesn't need a great big unit. They can rent a small unit, save the money, but yet it stores their goods, while they're off on break or maybe a semester abroad or over the summer. They can store that with us. And so I think that those are the sorts of things that we'll see going forward in the self-storage industry. I think what makes Moove In Self-Storage different is the people that work at Moove In Self-Storage. Every one of our stores has a full-time property manager. We have full-time relief staff, so they can work and give our full-time managers a day off from time to time. And so, we really pride ourselves in having great people that are manning our stores and really, have a heart and have the attitude to help other people. They need to be people that are helpful, kind of people, as you might say. And so I think that's what makes us different from most other self-storage facilities. That most people, when they come in and need to rent a self-storage facility, it's in a time of need. And so they're maybe stressed about it. It might be good stress, it may be bad stress, but they're kind of stressed about it. Hey, I need this storage for whatever reason, and can you help me? And our people are all about helping our customers get the storage space, renting or giving them, letting them use our rental truck for free, and doing some other things for them with locks and packing supplies, moving supplies, boxes, that sort of thing, to get them moved into the facility. So I think that's probably the first thing, is we have great people that are helping the customers. Second of all, we really do pride ourselves in having the nicest self-storage facilities, in the areas that we serve. We want them to be clean, we want them to be well located, we want them to offer lots of different sizes, we want them to be free of ice and snow in the winter time. We want the climate controlled spaces, the temperature controlled spaces, we want those cool in the summertime. So if you do rent one of those spaces, that everything's working in it. And we take pride in our facilities, and we'd like our customers to to appreciate that and know that they're in a facility that cares about their goods as much as they care about their goods. So I think those are some of the things that make self-storage, that make Moove In Self-Storage different. First of all, we like to make sure we hire the right person for the position. Again, want to hire somebody that's wakes up in the morning and is excited to go to work. They're happy. When you walk in the office, they stand up and they greet you and they say, "Hi, how are you today? How can we help out? How can we help solve your storage problem today?" And so they do that. We also spend a lot of time training our managers how to, handle phone calls, how to handle the customers when they're coming in and asking for various things that we can do. Our managers are also involved in a national program called the Certified Self-Storage Manager Program, and they actually get a designation. So they go to school. They take classes, go to school, they have to do projects, they have to do continuing education to keep the certification up. So if you go into any one of our stores, and if the manager has been with us for any time at all, I think more than 3, 4, 5 months, we've put them through the Certified Self-Storage Manager Program, and you'll see on their business cards their name with a CSSM designation. And I believe there are only about 250 managers all across the country and all of the United States that have that designation, and our managers have that. So we're very, very proud of that. And I think that really, really helps them be the best they can be for our customers. I think you could choose us for a lot of reasons. And I think probably the number one reason is our managers. We've got great people. We have managers in each of the stores 6 days out of the week. Even on Saturdays, we have hours there to make sure that we're there to help you and get you moved in and answer any questions you might have. And again, provide that super customer service that that we strive to provide, you know, every day. Another consideration is security. Our facilities are fenced. They have security cameras. You have to punch a gate code to get into the property, and you also have to punch a gate code to get out of the property. So we know who's there, who went in, what time they went in, what time they left. So we provide great security to our customers to make sure that their goods are safe and sound. We've got great locations, you know, all over the markets that we serve. We want to make sure that we're in very convenient locations that are near your home or your business or in between, so that it's very convenient to use our facility. We're clean freaks. We want to make sure that the properties are clean, that the hallways are clean, and the snow is cleaned up in the wintertime, and the leaves are raked up in the fall, and the fence lines are clean, the weeds are sprayed. We spend a lot of time making sure that our properties are clean, and we hopefully that our customers appreciate that. We're well lit. In the wintertime, it gets dark at 4:30 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and our facilities are open till 10 o'clock at night. And so we want to make sure that they're well lit. So when you're there visiting your goods, you know, dropping stuff off or picking stuff up that you can see, and it's well lit and provides a safe environment for you. Our access hours are from 6 in the morning till 10 o'clock at night, 7 days a week, 52 weeks a year. So again, we want to make sure that you have access to the stuff during the hours that you need access to it. We have retail stores at our locations. So if you need locks and boxes and packing, moving supplies, everything you may need in your self-storage experience, we have for sale. We have great prices on our boxes, much better than most places that provide boxes that are of similar quality to what we provide. You know, boxes that are mover quality boxes aren't going to fall apart after 3 or 4 months of use. We have some of the newest stores in the marketplace. I think our oldest store was built in the late 90s, but we really take time to make sure all the deferred maintenance is taken care of, and we freshen them up all the time to make sure that even though they may have a few years on them, but they look new. So we always want to have the newest, brightest stores in the marketplace. We're very excited about our online presence now. We have a wonderful website that's full of information to help you make the most of your storage experience. You can pay your bill online, you can rent a unit online, you can check on your stuff online. With a new program we have with cameras, you're going to be able to actually view your unit through our website. So we have lots of stuff that's coming on the website, on the digital side of things, and with all today's technology. So we're excited about that. We offer free rental trucks at almost all of our locations. We have Penske trucks, Penske rentals at a number of our locations as well to help you in your moving experience. And, I mentioned managers first, our people. And I think I'll come back to that. I think I've got to say that we've got the nicest people in the industry. We're proud about that. So hopefully you'll come and visit us.